Good morning, all of you. On the behalf of Dr. Vitthal Rao Vikhe Patil Foundation's Medical College, I welcome all of you. I request our respected Dean Sir to guide and say the intention behind this arrangement of this webinar. Thank you, sir. Sir, please.
Good morning to all. I, Dr. Sunil Maske, welcomes you all in this online lecture series. Especially today's eminent speaker, Dr. Shete Madam. She is a real academician and researcher. We will be benefited by her knowledge and whatever experience she has in this field. And I welcome and congratulate for this session, those which is organized by our team. So I welcome madam and I will proceed. Thanks again.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, ma'am, and all the delegates. Our today's guest speaker, Dr. Anjali Shete ma'am, is presently working as professor and head, Department of Physiology at Government Medical College and Hospital, Baramati. Ma'am has vast experience of undergraduate and postgraduate teaching. She has completed the advanced course in medical education from KEM Hospital, Mumbai, certificate course in leadership training, skills training, WHO health aging course, certificate course in geriatric medicine, and many more. She is approved faculty member by the MUHS for basic MET course, basic and advanced research methodology workshop. She is also a resource person at National Workshop of Training for Geriatric Care, Basic Research by Institute of Applied Statistics, Dehradun, and ICMR, and for various CMEs. As a coordinator, she has conducted workshops on communication skills, MET, and research methodology. She was nodal officer for skill development courses at Government Medical College, Aurangabad. Having more than 35 publications at various national and international journals and more than 220 citations, she has received the MedWorld Asia International Excellency in Research, Clinical Practice and Medical Evaluation Award in 2020. So I request ma'am to please start with her session. Ma'am, please.
Thank you very much. Good morning, all. Namaste, sir. And Dr. Sandeep Tadu, sir, who is organizing secretary of this particular workshop. And I really thank Dr. Vishal Indurkar, who has given me a nice introduction. So, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Just a kind request to all the participants that their mic should be silent. We can take it. Just a kind request to all the participants. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, just make a kind request to silent the mics. No disturbance.
Yes, ma'am, please proceed.
Yes, thank you very much. So I'll just proceed with today's talk. And at the beginning only, I would like to thank you, Dr. Vikhe Maske, sir, the Vikhe Patil College team, the organizing secretary, Dr. Sandeep Kadu, sir, and for a very nice introduction, Dr. Vishal Indurkar, sir. I just would like to share my views on this particular topic, which has been given as a part of CM. So today I'm going to discuss regarding how the students' professional development and how we can empower the woman. But this particular story I'm going to tell or share with my, along with my story. So I just want to have personal experiences and personal development, how I develop myself with my experiences and with my views. I would like to have this discussion. This is a vast topic actually. can be a part, two parts with which we can proceed further. Then I would like to have particularly this meeting with my journey. How I begin this complete career of being a doctor, being a medical professional, and that too being in the teaching profession. This journey was just to share my experience. I'm a physically challenged person. So I was born with a congenital deformity by which I was throughout the childhood, I was most of the time on wheelchairs. I have been operated up till now 17 times. So there was a disease particular which is known as congenital fibrodysplasia. And personally, I'm a physically challenged person. So whole of my childhood was most of the time with the wheelchair. But then as I grew up, it has been shifted with the help of the crutches. I was able to walk. So it was being changed from a wheelchair to the chair. And now presently, I'm walking with these type of calipers. So definitely, still I need the particular support to walk. You go through this from the wheelchair, from being to the calipers only, I feel like this. I'm really happy because I'm independent. And I can walk throughout this particular journey without any assistance. So this is a complete childhood story of my disease actually. And due to this particularly physically challengedness, I had to have different patterns. Like there was really difficulties in during the childhood, how to pursue my whole of the childhood was having, as I have told, 18 operations were there. And with these 18 operations, now I'm able to stand and walk properly. But these 18 operations were such beautiful operations that I was really independent and very much walking through this career path. So to begin with, how I started this. So I know for a person who is having everything, but I still remember my childhood, that since childhood, I have not played any games. I have not at all run at a single time. And these were issues I was facing. And then as the career goes on, I was having the habit of reading. I was a very bright student, and my family, my the teachers were supportive. And that every time I was in contact with the doctor, so I developed an attraction towards this medical profession, which is a noble profession. Really, I believe that due to these doctors only I'm able to walk, I'm able to stand. And that much respect I have for these medical professionals. And due to that, I had an attraction. Yes, I have to be a doctor. And with this determination, I, throughout the childhood, throughout my college period, I was studying hard to get an MBBS admission. Finally, I had an admission at GMC Nagpur. Now, when I went there, it was too difficult for me with the help of crutches, auxiliary crutches, to leave at the hostel. So again, there were so many problems, the issues which I had to face. But I had have a supportive family with which I can change that. And then I shifted in the second round, as you all are aware, to the GMC Aurangabad. And in the year 1991, I was admitted in medical college, Government Medical College, Aurangabad. And till then, from that time onwards, I was there in the GMC or not. Now, for the first year, it was very easy for me to conduct your education. It was really very easy. I was happy that I'm going to become a doctor with the help of cancers, with the help of all the support systems. I can go through the first year. But when I landed in the second year and the clinical posting started, then the problem again began. So So in the second year itself, within the 6 months, I had 6 fractures. And due to that, again, I had to undergo 3 major surgeries. And then at that time, my orthopedic surgeons, they told me that, look, Anjali, tula jar chalaycha asel, tar tu hi medical profession sodun de. This is not for you. And if you want to have this particular pain throughout your life, then it's your own decision. You have to walk with the help of auxiliary crutches throughout the life. And these were the sentences which were told to second year MBBS student who just really wanted to have that particular career throughout her life. And that was told to me in the second year. It was really devastating. But I really thank definitely my teachers and my family. And the hero of my life is always my father. And he stood by me and he said, if you want to become a doctor, then you have to bear this particular stress. You have to bear this pain and then move forward. Whatever it may be. Let's the challenge, you accept it, the challenge, you accept your position and then proceed forward. So that is how I began to think. When I completed somehow the second year, somehow the third year, then came again the part of internship. It was really hard to listen from the patients. Ki doctor, tumhala chalta yet nahi hai, toh tumhi humche kya treatment karna. This was the question, or this was the things which daily I had to listen. But I had to be calm and patient because I wanted to have the degree of MBBS. So again, with the help of auxiliary crutches, I was having terrific pain in whole of the lower limbs, in the spinal cord, and due to the auxiliary crutches throughout the walking, I was having the auxiliary compression, nerve compression. The heart pain dukhacha, atala mungya yacha. So I was not able to walk properly. And if you, at that time, if you look at me, I was really, asa vatayacha ki he patientach ahe. Khup jast patient ahe. Ani kharokhar atta mala asa samajta ya age ki tyancha kahi chukat nahi. They were telling the same, whatever they were seeing. So I thought that, ki asa aplyala he sagale lok sangtay, mhanje something is there. Something which I'm not communicating properly to the public. So I had to again change myself. And at that particular time, I shifted from rural urban internship posting to rural internship posting. I was posted at Patsod, which is 60 kilometers away from Aurangabad. There were no mobile phones. There were no vehicle for me. But my dad said, if you had to go, then you have to travel by bus. You try क्रचेस घे तुझे क्रचेस घेऊन तुला कसं बस मध्ये ट्रॅव्हल करायचं आणि काय घेऊन तू ट्रॅव्हल करू शकतेस हे दोन वाक्य त्यांनी सांगितले होते मला. 6 months I was there attending whole of that. I was really crying at that time because my father, he was actually on a very nice government post. He was having a vehicle, but still he refused to give me that vehicle. He said, की नाही तुला हे करायचं असेल तर तुला हे तुझं तुझं करावं लागेल. आय विल नॉट बी ऑलवेज देअर टू हेल्प. डेफिनेटली इफ यू आर लँडिंग अप इन एनी प्रॉब्लम आय विल बी देअर टू हेल्प यू, बट दिस इज नॉट द केस दॅट एव्हरी टाइम आय शुड बी. सो यू हॅव टू गो अलोन, ॲडजस्ट युअर लाईफ अँड वॉट एव्हर प्रॉब्लम्स यू हॅव टू फेस. अँड नाव रिअली आय रिअलाइज दॅट पर्टिक्युलर टाइम विच वॉज द इंटर्नशिप टाइम, इट वॉज अ physical, mental challenge for me, and that developed a very empowered student inside me and an empowered woman inside me. So I was really empowered. So at that particular time, it was a support, a positive support, the positive sayings from someone who can help you and someone who can guide you, gives a direction to your whole of life. So I was continuously doing all these things. I completed my internship, and at our times it was the post graduation which was given on the basis of third MBBS marks. So I was getting a clinical branch, pediatrics branch, but then again my doctor said, ki again beta, I'm telling you, you want to be in this particular profession, by any means you can help the others. So really think again, don't opt for the clinical branch, go for something other branch, and then you can proceed further in your life without anything. So at that particular time, again, I had to take a very hard decision. It was really hard to leave the pediatric seat, and I had to opt for physiology.
Sorry, ma'am, to disturb you. Hello, ma'am.
Yes. Yes.
Ma'am, your slides are not changing. Some technical problem is there. Please do the slideshow, ma'am.
Okay. Now it is changing?
Not yet, ma'am.
It's not changing?
Slideshow? Not. No, ma'am. Please do slideshow. Now it's changed. But, you go on the mode slide change. Slideshow.
Okay. Yes, it's on slideshow.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, no problem. No.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So then I decided to have this physiology, which is a very noble profession, and I completely, my whole of the 22 years of my career now have been allotted to physiology, and the confidence, the career, the whatever you have told right now, Dr. Vishal Indukar has given the introduction, it was just due to the physiology profession. I really respect my subject, and I really respect my subject, and I really say that the teaching profession, the medical teaching profession, is the best teaching profession which we can have. So this was a short life story of mine. I just wanted to share with you that with the saying that the world, when the world says give up, always there is a hope which whispers, try it one more time. And this is how I have moved forward. This is the one word which I always had always in mind, that try it one more time. Acha, ye samajh nahi aayega, azum ekda karunga. Then you can do. Even in day-to-day life also, still I have to do and I have to move forward like this. Okay, so this is a just short life story. I don't think that this was a very difficult task for me, because personally, my family and my support system was very good. But many of the times you don't have this good support system, you don't have the good family support, then you have to develop this particular empowerment, the professional development by yourself. And by my experience, I'm just going to tell you that how this can be developed. So this is why I have jotted it down. Dr. Sandeep Kadu, sir, is it visible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Yes, so whenever you have to change yourself, like if you have to have a professional development, and I know there is like no one will be physically challenged like me, or some might be, some might not be. With the help of your normal healthy beings, you have to have the professional development. You have to have the professional empowerment. And for that, I have jotted down these particular points, that if you have these particular points, definitely you are going to have the empowerment. The first thing which you have to remember is that don't try to change others. It is always you have to be self-sufficient, and personally, you have to be very much empowered. So there should, your objective should be empowerment of yourself, and empowerment such that you should be self-sufficient. Try to find new opportunities and challenges, and that every day you have to. So you always have to find out the challenges day to day. Like us, like this, you have to have these particular ones. And whenever you are developing this, what you have to do is balance between the personal expectations priorities and what the society really wants from them. So if you are a medical student, if you are in a medical profession, maybe right now you are a student, an undergraduate student, a postgraduate student, or a faculty, you always have to think that what are your personal expectations, what is your own priorities, and what
Hello, ma'am.
That is in leadership. So whenever ma'am, you are developing yourself, definitely your group empowered will be there and your skills of leadership will be changed. Okay. Yes, sir. Is there any problem?
The slide is not changing, ma'am.
Still it is not changing because it is showing. It is showing that it is changed.
Only that quote is there.
What do you think empowerment is? Is it shown?
No, no. That slide, the quote slide is there. When the world says give up, first try it one more time. That slide we are...
I will stop sharing it and then again start new share. Okay?
Okay, ma'am. Should I do it? Okay. Yeah, ma'am. Please proceed.
Yes. So what you have to do is like this. Sorry for the disturbance actually. Is it now visible? Is it now visible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Is it now visible?
Actually that slide, previous slide only we are viewing. No problem, madam. You can carry on. No problem. You can carry on, ma'am.
So what what your objective are is, as I have told you, that should be always leadership skills also. I just wanted to have and view regarding whatever 59 participants are there. What exactly you think? What is empowerment? What do you think? So from your side, the students probably or some of the faculty members can tell me what exactly is empowerment. Anyone? I can see Dr. Veeramala Lingaswamy. He has raised his hand. So can you tell me what is empowerment? Yes, anyone from the students? There are 58 participants. So can anyone tell what is empowerment?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes. Ma'am, kindly introduce yourself.
Myself, Dr. Mandar
Chandrachuri.
Myself, Dr. Mandar from community medicine.
Okay.
I feel empowerment means you are able to take your own decisions.
Your voice is not clear, sir.
I think empowerment means you are able to take your own decisions.
Okay. Any other views? Any from the students? This is from the teacher point of view. Yes, Harshada Jadhav. Is there any student who is attending this? Shitija. Kritija.
Hello, ma'am.
Any student? Yes.
Ma'am, I think woman empowerment means their ability to determine their own choices.
Okay, this is regarding the woman empowerment. Anything related to just a person empowerment? Deep Thakkar. Neha Patil. Yes, anyone who is attending. What do you think?
Hello, ma'am. Yes. Ma'am, probably it can be the emotional, physical, and even financial self-sufficient.
Okay, very nice. So she has added like the teachers, community sir has told something else, and now the students view. So there is a difference. What she has added is financial.
Ma'am, yes. We have only 7 minutes.
Yes.
Yes, if you want, we can rejoin if you want to extend.
Yes. So, what it is actually, by my experience, it is to operate by itself and with enthusiasm. So, whenever it is an empowerment, it is always you have to see that you have to operate something and you should operate it by yourself. And that too with enthusiasm. If you are doing all these things, then it is known as empowerment. Maybe it is a student personal empowerment, or if you are going to talk regarding the woman empowerment. So this is my view regarding this. So if you want to have the empowerment, it is always the responsibility and the ownership. So whatever you are doing, you should be responsible for that. And you should own your positive points also and your negative points also. You have to have the choice of working independently. It is always better if you're working in a group, but you should be able to stand out independently. You always have to have the question, why? Trying to understand why. Why this is it? If something I'm telling, your mind should ask the question, why it is there? If you are doing something, try to internalize about the impact of our own decision. Suppose you have taken the decision of being a doctor, then you have to internalize yourself. Try to develop or empower your emotional power such that your decision should internalize and it should empower your self-being. So it is always the empowerment is always an earned privilege. It is not a given right. So you have to try very hard to get the empowerment. Maybe it is a woman empowerment or maybe for a personal empowerment. So these are the things which you will have to have. But whenever we are trying to do the empowerment, remember empowerment is not being against the group. It's always said that bypassing the people who are saying no to you. आपल्याला ही नेहमीच अशी हॅबिट असते की कोणी जर आपल्याला अगेन्स्ट गेलं किंवा कोणी नाही म्हणून सांगितलं तर वी डायव्हर्ट अवर सेल्फ. नो, यू हॅव टू ट्राय टू फेस टू दीज नो पीपल्स ऑल्सो अँड नॉट अलॉंग ऑर फॉलोइंग द रूल्स. यू हॅव टू एम्पावर युअर सेल्फ. इट डझंट मीन दॅट यू कॅन टेक युनिलॅटरल डिसिजन. यू ऑलवेज हॅव टू थिंक ऑफ ऑल द थिंग्स अँड देन यू हॅव टू मूव फॉरवर्ड. And you can have a decision which is deciding or thinking of all the things. So you will always remember that it is not a unilateral decision. Now, if you want to have the empowerment, what we can do? First important thing is identify and develop the personal capabilities. Encourage others to learn with you. Transfer the work to those who execute the work. So as you grow up, as from the student, you develop the faculty, you always have to develop these capabilities. That first you identify and develop the personal capabilities, encourage the others. You transfer the work to those who execute the work. सगळं काम आपण एकट्याने करायचं नसतं. यू हॅव टू डिवाइड द वर्क अँड ट्राय टू फाइंड आउट दोज पर्सन्स विथ द कपॅबिलिटीज अँड ट्राय टू गिव्ह दीज टाईप ऑफ वर्क टू दोज हू कॅन वर्क. क्रिएट अँड वर्किंग एन्व्हायरमेंट वेअर एव्हरी वन वॉन्ट्स टू वर्क. सो इट शुड बी अन हॅपी वर्क. Remember, always people rise to the challenge when it is their challenge. So try to form a group or a group of person with a working environment that everyone thinks that this is their own challenge. And this is a physiological thing. Ki aapla kai asel tar apan tyachyasathi khup jaast hi bhavana tyanchya madhe aapalyala nirman karayachi aste. So that is people always try to challenge with if it is their challenge. Ask the questions to yourself. Whenever you have decided to empower yourself, ask yourself the questions. Is it ethical, whatever you have decided? Is it legal, whatever you have decided? What risks are associated with these particular decisions? Do I have enough information? If I have collected this particular information, do I have the enough information? Have I discussed with all the members of the team? And am I accountable for my own decisions? So these are the questions you always have to ask yourself whenever you are planning or whenever you are doing anything. And this is the part and parcel of your professional development. So if the professional development is there, you always have to think that success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that comes. So you just have to run the show, and you of course should have the courage to fight the lifestyle. And if that is the courage which is living there, then definitely success will be in your hands. Now, it was just related to the student empowerment. I will just have an highlight regarding woman empowerment, just 2 to 3 minutes, particularly because there are a lot of students who are females, and that too, they are having these particular problems. Now, if you think, are my slides visible now? You always have to think in the Indian scenario that if you see our women, they are always having with the powerless. Okay, we always see our Indian woman, we have to think of all the women, and if always think that our women are powerless, but they begin to develop. How they are going to develop? Because they will try to participate in different type of events. They try to participate themselves, they adapt the changes, and then they will change themselves into a leader pattern. You have the example of Sindhutai Sapkar. So she was very powerless. She tried to have an initiation. So she participated in various events, the adoption procedures, and finally, she was like a leader for all of us. You always have to think for the particularly 6 S, which are very important for the woman empowerment. That is, first S is Shiksha, second is Swasthya, third is Swavalamban, fourth is Samajik Nyay, the fifth is Samvedan, and the sixth is Samata. So to have in English, it is education, health, independence, justice, sensitivity, and equality. If you are having these 6 S, your woman group will be empowered. Now, what keeps behind the constraints in the woman empowerment is lack of education, the traditional limitation view, the financial constraint, the family responsibilities, the less mobility and less ability to bear the risk, and the conflicts among the woman groups also. So if you study further, these are the things which keeps us behind. The woman empowerment keeps us behind. So you have to change yourself. Now, what are the changes which we expect if you have to be empowered woman? There should be improved personal knowledge. You should self-define yourself. You should be authentic, creative. You should have the physical strength, they should be equal, there should be economic independence, it should be freedom from oppression, and having all these, you have a power in the society, and then the woman is termed as empowered woman. So I'll end up this particular session of having this, a strong woman has faith that she is strong enough for the journey, but a woman of strength has faith that it is the journey that she will become strong. So I always believe in this particular saying that every woman, every person, if you believe your journey, that gives the strength and the faith, and that becomes the empowerment of yourself. Maybe it is a male person, maybe it is a female person, but the empowerment is extending my session. So thank you very much.
Thank you, madam, for your encouraging, inspiring lecture. I hope students will benefit positively henceforth about their life, considering your struggle of life. And we are, I request participant, if you have any question, any queries or any questions, they can ask to the madam.
Yes, sir.
Even they can message their question in chat,
yes,
box.
They can message the questions, or I think they have left the meeting, many of them.
I think, madam, because of the technical issue, some of them are not.
Technical issues, I think the participants have differed from them. Participants, they are there. If you have any question, you are free to ask. Or you can type the questions in the chat box.
I think participants don't have questions. So I take this opportunity to end this meeting by giving vote of thanks. I, Dr. Indurkar Vishal, on behalf of Dr. Vittal Rao Vikhe Patil Foundation Medical College, Ahmednagar, would like to convey our most sincere vote of thanks to respected Dr. Anjali Shete Madam, Professor Head of the Department of Physiology, Baramati, Government Medical College, Baramati. Madam, thank you very much for your encouraging and inspiring lecture. It is just like our topic, Rise of Phoenix. It really like that. And I hope the student will take positive message from this today's lecture. And I also thank to all the participants who enthusiastically participated in today's lecture. Thank you very much. And last but not the least, I thank our management, college management, who allow us to conduct this session. And also thanks to respected Dr. Dean Sunil Natha Maske, for allowing us and encouraging us to conduct such activity for student and our staff members. Thank you very much, madam. I declare here to end this meeting. Sir?
Yes.
No? Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
Vishal, sir.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, Vishal, sir. Thank you, Dr. Yes. And thank you all the participants for bearing me for this much time. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.